Salut tout le monde, in this video, I'm going to show you to install an Octua cooler on a 1700 socket. I start by taking out the different elements from the box and open the one that contains the bracket. In the box, there are two manuals, one for Intel and one for AMD. I have an Intel processor, so I set aside the AMD manual. Noctua has done a good job with the packaging. The box is divided into several compartments. The left side is for Intel, the right for AMD, and the bottom part contains the accessory common to both processor brands. I retrieve the parts from the left side and the accessories, and I don't touch the AMD parts. Before I start the assembly, I check that I have everything I need. The necessary components are the backplate, the mounting bars. In the bag on the right, there are 4 thumb screws and 4 black spacers. The socket on my motherboard is an LGA 1700, so I won't need the black spacers. But I will need the blue ones that are in the other bag, as well as 4 clips-on spacers and 4 bolts. Now that I have checked that I have all the necessary parts, I'm going to move on to installing the backplate. Here you need to pay attention to the side of the plate that will go towards the motherboard. This is the side where it says this side must face the motherboard. On the other side, it says SecuFirm. I'm going to put the screws in the plate. The holes are diamond shaped and the base of the screws is triangular. This is because there are 2 possible positions for the installation. Position 1 for socket 1200 and 1150, and position 2 for the socket 1700. So here I'm going to place my screws in position 2, which is more towards the edge. The position numbers are written on the back of the plate. I install my 4 screws and secure them with the clip-on. If you have any leftover clips, it's normal as Noctua has provided 2 extra. Now I need to flip the motherboard to install the backplate. Here we are at the back of the socket, and on my motherboard, the screws go into the outermost holes. Once the backplate is installed, I can flip the motherboard again. I install the blue spacer that corresponds to my socket. And then I put on the brackets. There are 3 holes on the brackets, and with my socket, the screws should pass through the holes in the position 2. In my PC, I install the bracket horizontally so that the heatsink is vertical and the airflow passes horizontally in the case. If you have an exotic configuration and want the airflow to be vertical, you'll need to mount the brackets vertically, which correspond to orientation B. Next, I apply the thermal paste. I'm using the one that came with the cooler, and I'm following Noctua's recommendation on how to apply it, which is a pea-sized dot in the center and 4 dots about 2 mm in size in the corners. Then I move on installing the heatsink. It's a bit counterintuitive, but before installing it, you need to remove the fan. Otherwise, you won't be able to access the mounting screws later. To remove the fan, I pull the metal clips towards me on both sides. If you have that small plastic protective cover at the base of the heatsink, remove it. I gently place the heatsink on the motherboard with the 2 screws resting on the pin that protrudes from the brackets. You need to screw them alternatively. Don't screw one completely and the other one next. Tighten one slightly, then the other, and so on. When you get to the end, don't over-tight. Stop as soon as you feel a little resistance. When I installed my heatsink, I wasn't paying attention and put it in the wrong direction, so the Noctua logo was upside down. The heatsink is symmetrical, so there is no problem with functionality, it's just an aesthetic issue. So check which way you want the logo to be before installing the heatsink. Before installing the fans, I have to install the RAM sticks. And now I can install the fan starting by the one that was on the heatsink out of the box. I'm taking the clips for the second fan from the accessory bag. Before installing, I need to check which way the fan needs to face. Based on the rotation of the component, it needs to blow towards the heatsinks. There is an arrow on the side of the fan indicating the direction it blows. So I install the clips accordingly. Next, I am attaching the fan to the heatsink, adjusting the height so that it's a little bit higher than the RAM. Now I need to connect the fans to the motherboard. You can choose to power them individually or using the same connection. I prefer to connect them both on the same ports of the motherboard. I'm using the adapter provided by Noctua to connect the fans, and then I plug it on the motherboard. If you're not sure which connector to use, consult the motherboard manual. Here I'm using connector A, which corresponds to CPU fan. If I wanted to control each fan separately, I would have plugged the second one in connector B or CPU optional. The installation of the cooler is done, I have made a video of the full PC build, I will put the link in the description. Once the PC is complete and Windows installed, I launch a Cinebench test to make sure everything is running smoothly. With Cinebench, the CPU temperature is around 50 degrees, so we can see that the Noctua cooler is doing a great job. I hope this video was helpful, subscribe for more videos like this, thank you for watching and see you next time!